everyone, I'm Olivia from Mayfair Media and I'm here today with Raff, who is a British actor and producer. So welcome Raff, thank you very much for coming and seeing us today. So you may recognise Raff from films such as Quantum of Solace and Saving Private Ryan, but you've got a new project coming up. Well, a new project you're taking to New York next week, so do you want to tell the audience a little bit about that?
I made a film called Flynn the Movie and it took me 4 years to make, and we got into Raffaello's Film Festival.
Oh, wow.
We got a Biffa nomination, which was really great considering the amount of money we spent to make it, which is very minimal in terms of making films.
Yeah.
And I think it opened, well, it does, it opens at the New York Independent Film Festival next week.
It's really kind of exciting. Yeah. Oh, wow, amazing. And how did you kind of get into films? And obviously, you're an actor first and then producing. Can you kind of tell us how your journey started from into the acting world?
I actually started as a child and then I gave it up and then did various life experience journeys around the world, debauchery and all that, and then I came back to, I did a play in West End and sort of got more back into it in my 20s, yeah.
Okay, and how do you find it now, obviously you're an actor first, being used to front camera now behind, is it weird? How do you find it?
I like it.
Really?
Yeah, I like both. I mean, I just like being part of the whole thing, telling the story and finding a way to tell the story and bringing people in that I know and I like and just sort of building that chemistry, if you like, to tell the stories.
And Flynn was obviously made like a little bit differently, like you mentioned about the scripts, a different process. How did that?
Well, it was improvised, but with a story structure based on a sort of American way of improvisation called the Harold. But yeah, I'd go home and try and feed that into some sort of cohesive narrative. And I sort of figured out a sort of criminal investigation underneath it so that it would be more interesting to watch, not just comedy. And I think we managed to get the two layers that we wanted.
And what is the story about? What is the place?
It's basically on a surface, it's about a Bollywood filmmaker trying to make it in Hollywood. And then you follow this guy through the eyes of an amateur documentary team. And by the end of it, you figure out that it's actually the police footage and it's evidence against him in a court of law, and then it becomes whether this guy's guilty or not. Crimes.
Interesting, okay. And as an actual producer, obviously, like you've kind of done this now, you've created this thing, what is the next step for you? What do you see happening next?
I want to continue doing both.
Okay.
It fills the mind in the way I want to work. I've written another script with an actor. Writer Alex Giannini unfortunately passed away last week, but we worked on it for a few years, and I think I'm ready to use that as a framework to film in the way I like to film. So I've got a rough idea how I want the story to go, but I'm going to figure it out en route based on the actors I cast or become those
characters
and the
characters way that they kind of create it
and how it develops. But I've got an idea of a one act, one act two and act three, and I feel that, and I think
And being an action producer in London, how do you, I mean obviously going to New York next week, but how do you find London as a creative space for you know, kind of creative industries?
I feel really comfortable in London.
Okay.
When I travel around, I don't feel that comfort in LA. But I mean, I am from London, even though I've got such an obscure name. I'm a Londoner, so I feel comfortable here, and I think, you know, things
you
are changing.
There's opportunities for actors and creators like yourself. I think London's a good place.
I think there's so much that they can do here. I think there's so much people can just get up and do on their own, rather than look for other people to help them. And there's all sorts of people ready to step forward, you know, and it's a city that's moving forward.
Yeah.
It's embracing all the cultures that are coming in. It's been a difficult journey.
Yeah, but you feel like it's at a peak now. Yeah, no, I agree. And we've seen that across multiple creative industries, like Fashion Week, London, I think this year, for me, has been one of the biggest London Fashion. Everyone I've spoken to said London was the one for them this year.
Really?
So, yeah, I think because, you know, you have like in Paris, you have Chanel, I think they're so big, but London's really braced up for new emerging talent. I think that's always been a common theme in London, all the good people kind of train here, whether it's in theatre or fashion or whatever. But on a slightly lighter note, if you could cast any actors in your new next film, literally any actors, who would you cast?
That's a difficult question because I can't just pick an actor for the sake of them being it has to fit into the role.
Yeah.
But You know, I just I've worked with so many amazing actors. Mm. They're famous or non-famous. Everybody's got such an interesting quality about them.
Yeah.
I love meeting actors full stop.
Yeah.
That are committed and interesting and unique. So can I not give you any names and just say I'm
lots.
I just think, you know, I love meeting new people. Yeah. Over here.
Okay, you've got to give me a name for this one. If you could play any character, established character already, what would that be?
A character film.
A film character, yeah.
Jeez. I think it would be Billy Hayes in Midnight Express.
I don't know
what film
that is.
Yeah.
Obviously, I need
Billy
to.
Billy Hayes, I can't remember. Wasn't that? Anyway, he was the lead actor. It was shot in this, I think it was in the late 70s or 80s.
Okay.
It was based on a true story of this guy who went to Turkey and he got arrested at the airport for trying to bring some marijuana back to the United States. He got life in prison and it was about his journey to escape. It's an incredible story.
Wow.
But the actor who played it, who's now dead, unfortunately, was. Extraordinary.
Maybe you couldn't have played it better.
No chance. He nailed it.
Okay, and our last question is, who's your biggest movie crush?
My biggest movie crush has got to be... Al Pacino in Serpico.
Okay.
And Robert De Niro in The King of Comedy.
Very nice.
And Robert De Niro
in
Raging Bull, and Joe Pesci in Raging Bull, and
any females?
Yeah, Meryl Streep in The Bridges of Madison County.
Okay.
Meryl Streep in Doubt. Philip Seymour Hoffman in Doubt. Viola Davis in Doubt. I love that.
And our final question is, because I'm assuming we will have some young British actors or producers or scriptwriters watching this. If you could give anybody any advice, any newcomers to the British film industry, what would that be?
To the British film industry? As filmmakers or actors?
Anything, absolutely. Any creative wants to get involved in the British film,
well,
especially now.
I would say, having learned over 20 years, look for a reason to make it happen rather than looking for a reason to not make it happen. Yeah.
That's good. Okay.
At any level.
Yeah. Oh, well, thank you very much, Raff. Thank you very much for joining us, and we look forward to hearing about all your adventures when you come back from New York next week.
Yeah, I look forward to it.
Everyone, make sure you follow our social media links and, of course, Raff, and we will see you soon. Thanks.